I'm Justine Hardy and I'm Deputy Head at UTC Plymouth. And today we are beach cleaning and doing our bit for our local community in a sustainable way on Drake's Island. So today our students have been moving and collecting some of the larger pieces of litter that have floated in from the mainland. Not only that, but we have also been collecting some of the microplastics, some of the teeny tiny little bits that at school the children have been learning are causing absolute devastation. So it's really great for them to see this in action.
My name's Helen and I'm a science teacher at UTC Plymouth. So Eco School is a big project that lots of schools around the globe actually take part in. The aim is to get kids involved as a student-led process in looking at things that to do with the environment. So we've had an eco committee, totally made out of students. They've decided the priorities that we want to look at for this year. They've decided on biodiversity, the marine environment and healthy living. So this kind of fits into the biodiversity and the marine environment side of that.
These guys are our eco ambassadors, so they'll be spreading the message. They have actually played a huge part in our school getting its green flag status, which we're really, really proud of. We've been building links with Till the Coast is Clear. Plymouth City Council are coming to take away a lot of the rubbish, and also cultivating that relationship with Drake's Island that we're starting to build. It's been fantastic. As if that wasn't enough, we've also been identifying some of the rubbish that we can use to make an art installation in our workshops. Our examination students will be creating that piece, and we'll bring it back to the island to be installed in terms of raising awareness, in order to raise awareness for our local community.
I'm Roxy and today we're doing a beach bean with other students from the Eco School. So we're basically taking out any metal, any plastic that we find, any nets away and put them in these bags that then can be hopefully recycled.
Hiya, I'm Jake. I'm an art teacher at UTC and I've spearheaded a beach clean here today with some of our Eco School young men and women. So there's ambassadors from year 7, 9 and 10 who have all come here of their own volition to help us clean the beach here on Drake's Island. It's really a two-pronged idea, so fundamentally it's to come help clear the beach of all the waste here and also to educate the young men and women here that have come here to really be aware of what washes up on their doorstep and how dangerous it is and how long it can take to break down. And then even when it's broken down, it's then even more dangerous for marine wildlife. Taking all this lovely rubbish with us back to school, we're then going to be designing and creating some sort of sculpture from the waste that we find that really sends home that message about both the quantity and the variety of things that wash up on our beaches in Plymouth, but also creating some sort of sea creature out of it that we can get beauty out of the real horror of so much plastic and other pollution that's washing up on our beaches.
So I'm Gary Jolliffe from Till the Coast is Clear. Until the Coast is Clear is a social enterprise or a community interest company that specialises in recovering plastic pollution from difficult to reach places along our coastlines. So we also campaign for a better understanding of what damage plastic pollution and other pollution does to our oceans. And basically it's just a big team effort to try and clear up the mistakes we've made in the past and to make sure we do things better in the future.
For the past hour we've been mining up this
We one. Started, yeah. Kieran joined and someone else came over but he's gone to another project now.
Yeah, and we never gave up. It was wedged in right in the hole over there and it was filled up with a load of hard sand and rocks, so we had to take it all out, get it out again. It took us about an hour, didn't it?
It took us the entire time we got him.
Yeah, it took us the entire time.
He
but
saw
we
it.
Finally got it out. We never gave up, we endeavoured, so we are proud for what we've got.